Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about function and application of motor. Let us talk about motor first. What is motor? Motor is a bonding agent which is generally produced by mixing cementing or binding material, that is lime or cement, and fine aggregate such as sand, surki, sawdust, etc. with water. Motor is used to bind different binding blocks like bricks, stones, etc. It can also add a decorative pattern in brick or stone machinery. So generally, motor is nothing but a binding material which can be made up of cement or lime or by using sand. So generally, it is known as CM. We call it as CM, that is your cement mortar, or we can known as lime mortar also. And it should be in ratio of generally 1:3 or 1:6. We use in the ratio of this. And it is useful for the brick machinery or stone machinery for the binding purposes. Motor are usually named according to the binding material used in their preparation, as we have discussed already. They are essentially required for machinery work, plastering and pointing, etc. What are the functions of motor now? To bind together the bricks or stone properly so as to provide strength to the structure, so that your whole unit will act as a one unit. So generally it gives strength to the structure by binding each material. To form a homogeneous mass of the structure so as to resist all the loads coming over it without disintegration. So it will make the whole mass as a homogeneous mass. These are its functions. Now where the motor is applicable? As you can see, motor can be applied in the bricklaying, or we can say it is applicable for the stone machinery or brick machinery. As you can see, 1:1 if we have to set the bricks. So between two bricks, we have to apply a layer of mortar. Then it is used in plastering work. As you can see, this is the unfinished surface of your brick. After applying mortar over it and planing it, we will get this type of surfaces. That is known as plastering. We are preparing your wall for plastering purpose. So in the plastering, we have to throw the mortar over your brick surfaces or stone surfaces, and then by using the floats, we have to go in proper shape and thickness. Then the next function is pointing. Now what is pointing? Pointing means what? The gap between two bricks is known as pointing. So what we do when your structure gets old and we are going for the repair work, the loose mortar between two bricks is grooved off by using some grooving tools, and then it is filled by using a newly made mortar. This method is known as what? Pointing. So mortar is also used for pointing purposes. So these are the three applications of mortar, and which is very useful in construction industry. So in this video, we have seen what is mortar, what are its functions, and what are the applications of mortar. Thank you.